Hello guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. This video details how to convert raw data of the EFIX GPS instruments into a RINEX data. Now RINEX or receiver independent exchange format is a standardized format used to store and exchange GNSS data between different devices and software. It's an essential tool for surveyors and geospatial professionals who rely on EFIX survey instrument in Eoffice. Today, we are going to explore the process of converting raw data to RINEX, and I'll share some tips and tricks to help you master this crucial skill. Start by navigating to and launching the Eoffice software. The software takes a while to start. So you head over to your very first tab, that's the Stats tab. Then you click on the Create New Project. So you populate your new project properties by entering the name of your project. Then you can subsequently create a directory for your project. You confirm to open the Eoffice project surface interface. Now we are going to use a conventional method to quickly convert the raw data, that's the .ecn files, into its RINEX equivalent. So we go on to the GNSS tab, click on import, and then we subsequently navigate to the location of our file. So here are the raw data files. So we select them. And then we go to open. It takes a while to import the selected data into. And your pop-up shows seeking for you to confirm the data or the raw data file that you have imported. When you are satisfied with or make sure all the files are checked under the user use tab. And then you can confirm. You realize that all the files have or have been identified with a single name, hence they all been lumped up together. Now to be able to separate them, you come to our GNSS tab, you double click, and then we can subsequently edit the names or the station labels. And we go back to our map tab, and here we can see now the files have been properly or evenly distributed. So we go on ahead to the main reason for this video. You select all the files or the files you're seeking to convert. When all the files have been selected, you right click. So before we undertake the RINEXing, we go to our RINEX options and make sure we go our property files of the raw data have been properly set to meet our specification. And here, the RINEX version, we select our appropriate RINEX type. Mind you, some of the softwares are not able to interpret or access RINEX 3 or higher. So mostly you set it to the lower version type for easy access. Then you come to a splitting interval, which we most likely leave it on default. We make sure observation type files are all ticked, or in the event you don't want any, you can uncheck them. And then we set our frequency. And most importantly, we will make sure to select our appropriate satellite system. You can check any of them off if you feel you might not need them, or a system is not able to track effectively. So all the settings have been put in place. We click, and finally we can apply this to either all the selected file, all files, or if in the event you want to select a section of them and apply to it, we do likewise. So we click on all files and then we go on confirm. So now that the settings are in place, we likewise right click, and then we go to convert to RINEX. You can see our system here converting all the files into each RINEX equivalent. When it is done, it gives a prompt asking us to go open our directory where our RINEX file is. So it takes us into a directory created by the project to store our RINEX data. So here we have it, guys. Our EFIX survey instrument or raw data files have been successfully converted into its RINEX equivalent. You can subsequently use this in any third-party processing software like the Topcon tools, the Tremble Business Center, or the Leica Infinity, and a whole lot. And that's it all, guys. By following these steps, you should be able to convert raw data to RINEX using the EFIX surveying instrument in Eoffice. Remember, mastering this process is crucial for efficient surveying, and with practice, you'll become a pro in no time. Thanks for watching, and I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. Have you ever struggled with converting raw data to RINEX? What challenges did you face, and how did you overcome them? Also, be sure to check out our next video in advanced surveying techniques. It's packed with tips and tricks to take your skills to the next level.